Paris last month. It's all next on Larry King Live. Player Yanni has been making music for more than a decade. Last month, he made tabloid headlines when his girlfriend called 911 with claims of domestic violence. Yanni joins me here in the studio to talk about it for the first time. But first, let's listen to the audio tape of that phone call to the authorities.
Hey, what's the problem there, ma'am? Inside the house?
Yes.
Is he still inside the house?
Yes, I don't know.
All right, what is your... All right, just stay inside, stay in the room locked, and we'll send an officer over to meet with you, okay?
Okay.
All right, bye-bye.
My girlfriend was Sylvia Barthas. We invited her to appear, the woman who accused Yanni of domestic battery. The invitation was declined. There is a statement from her attorney, which says a civil lawsuit will be filed this week against John Y. Christopher, or a.k.a. Yanni, Sylvia Barthas, relating to a recent incident which resulted in the arrest of Yanni and other matters. Ms. Barthas attempted to resolve these issues with Yanni privately and without resort to litigation and the media. However, based on Yanni's public discussion of the matters, this is no longer possible. There was a criminal charge that was dismissed.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
What happened?
Well, it's a very painful time. It's been 30 days I've been sequestered at my house. I sat there and I watched everybody talk and tell their side of the story, and I am able to talk, and I appreciate you having me on.
My pleasure.
To speak. It was a case where, if I want to jump to the most dramatic aspect of what happened, was I wanted to end up my relationship with Ms. Barthas.
Had you been seeing her for some time?
Yeah, I met her about a year and a half ago, but the relationship was casual at the very beginning, because I was touring. I was beginning my tour. I was rehearsing. I went on tour for about 6 months, so it was difficult to even start a relationship with anyone. But I liked her. She had a lot of life. She liked to have a lot of fun, go out, and it was a good energy. And so we became close, and we talked on the phone quite a lot. That particular night, though, I think what happened is she just lost it for a few seconds.
You didn't harm her at all?
No, absolutely not. She just lost it for a few seconds. That's all it was, and came flailing at me. And I just put my arms up to protect my face. I just was able to grasp your arms at some point. But at that point, she became very aggressive.
Where was this?
That was in my house. It was
in Florida?
In Florida, yeah. We just come back.
Well, were you in some kind of hostile discussion?
It wasn't a hostile discussion. It was a discussion where I was just telling her, I think this would be the end. I think she would have to go home, that I would like to end our relationship.
And she didn't want that to happen?
No, she wasn't very happy about it.
Were you shocked, though, that she would call 911?
Yes. That really shocked me. I didn't expect it. I was standing at the door. It's a guest bedroom. And she was laying on the bed with her legs crossed, propped up against the pillows on the bed. And she just looked at me and said, "I'm just going to tell him you beat me up." And I just, "You're going to tell him what?" I couldn't believe it. I was just completely stunned. And then she proceeded to call 911. And
you were there when she called?
Yes, I was standing right there.
Listening to the whole conversation.
Yes, absolutely. I was watching her do it. And then about halfway through the 911 call, when she started saying he beat me up, I just realized something's wrong here. So I just went downstairs and I told my assistant, who was at the house, I had asked him to stay that night until Ms. Barthas left the house. I said, "Call the police. There's something going on here. I don't understand."
Didn't the police come to the house where she...
Yeah, they came within a minute or two, because the police station is maybe four blocks away.
And did they take notations from you and her?
Yeah, mostly they talked to her.
Did she file a criminal charge?
She pressed charges, so I don't know what the actual term is. You know, she was pressing charges.
And what happened to those charges?
They were dismissed.
By the court?
Not by court. It was not brought to court by the state attorney's office.
Right. They didn't think they had enough to go on.
They never brought charges against me.
We just saw a picture of it taken by the police. Was there any physical damage to her body?
There was. There was a little. I never hit her. I never slapped her. I never saw it happen. That was the whole thing. It was just, I never understood what happened. It was a very quick thing. She came playing on me. I was able at some point to grasp her arms. And at that point, she got very violent. She started kicking and swinging wildly. And I couldn't even hold on to her. So I just let go and walked away from the room for a little while.
You think she might have got hurt during that grabbing?
It's possible, but I never saw it happening. That's the interesting thing. I never knew how it happened.
How do you feel about the fact that her attorney tells us that a civil lawsuit will be filed this week?
I don't like that, but it's not... I was expecting that. It was not... I will defend my innocence very vigorously.
Have you seen her since this incident?
No, I have not, nor have I heard from her.
Have you ever had anything like this with any prior girlfriend?
Never. Not even close.
Because for a long time you were with Linda Evans, right?
Yes, I was.
Are you still friendly with her?
Yes, oh yes.
Did she call you after this?
Not personally, but she called my family. And she offered her support. But I just didn't want to bring into this.
What's it done to you?
This has been one of the most painful periods of my life. I've been sequestered at the house for 30 days and I've been able to go out and just kind of able to say anything. I'm able to talk.
While there were criminal charges pending.
Yes, I mean, until the state attorney's office made their decision. The interesting thing is that about a few days after this incident, I got a letter from your lawyers hand-delivered to my home. Even though they knew I had a lawyer, they knew who my lawyer was. We were asking for money, a settlement, without litigation. And that was 2 weeks before the state attorney's office had made up their mind or made their decision.
Are you saying they're trying to extort you?
Yes.
Because she says they try to settle it amicably. Is that what you mean by that letter to you?
No, that was not a letter of settling. This was a letter, I think, that was extortion.
Well, according to you, since there was no violence and you weren't, there's no promissory here, what was there to settle, right?
Exactly.
You had a relationship, you broke up.
Exactly. I just wanted to do that.
Happens every day.
I want it to be peaceful ending, too.
Because no one has a more peaceful image than you. Your music is peaceful.
Thank you.
You just kind of have a peaceful look. People don't expect this of Yanni.
Thank you, that's good. And Yanni doesn't do that. Yanni does not hit, and I do not slap, and I do not hit people and break their lips and all that stuff.
We'll take a break, and we'll be back with Yanni on this edition of Larry King Live. Don't go away. Palm Beach County said the alleged incident took place behind closed doors without any independent witnesses or evidence to support the charge. It became he said, she said. How's your health? There was a tabloid story claiming you lost a dramatic amount of weight and were very, very sick.
That was earlier, a few months before this. They were saying maybe I had cancer, throat cancer, something, I was dying. It's completely untrue.
You are in the helpless mind.
Yes, yes.
Do you think this has hurt you with fans?
I hope not. I've gotten so much outpouring of support and sympathy, and I know most of the fans don't believe it and didn't believe it, even though I the only story that was out there was hers for the past month.
Before you told her of a breakup, you had at dinner that night, right?
Yeah.
Did you know she was emotional, the kind of high-strung?
Yeah, she was emotional. She was an emotional person. Yeah.
So did you have any apprehension?
Yes, I did have apprehension, but I wasn't even planning to tell her that night. We just went to dinner. This has been going on for a couple of months. I think our relationship was not doing very well, and we both knew it. And, you know, sometimes when things just not work in a relationship, you find things to argue about that are not related Too bad you're just talking maybe about the dishes or the car or all this other stuff. But really, the truth of the matter is that the relationship is not working.
Was there ever a time you thought this could be a lasting relationship?
You know, that's a really good question. It's crossed my mind, yes. Yeah, whenever you enter a relationship, you hope. Yes.
You liked her?
Yes, I liked her.
Did she travel with you?